Big government makes people poorer. Welcome to Unfiltered. I'm SE Cupp. That was Florida Senator Marco Rubio in 2012, espousing the virtues of limited government, like good conservatives do, or did, rather. Now the party of Trump has been so brain scrambled that big government is back, big time. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, in the midst of a re-election year and presumably building a 2024 presidential platform, is perhaps the biggest big government proponent this side of Donald Trump. He's passed a raft of big government bills that insert politicians where they never belonged before, at least according to conservatives. There's the Don't Say Gay bill, which prohibits any discussions about sexuality and gender at school from kindergarten through third grade, disguising an anti-LGBTQ law as parental rights. To be clear, it's just more government control. There's the Disney bill that foists government control over a private company, punishing a corporation for speaking out publicly against the Don't Say Gay bill. This was once a big no-no on the right. Or there's the woke bill, which puts restrictions on how schools and businesses can talk about race and gender. More big government. A new congressional map, which conveniently eliminates two districts represented by Black Democrats, because if you can't win new voters, just use the government to limit their power. And the latest bill, well, it's a big government orgy. DeSantis has created the ominous-sounding Office of Election Crimes and Security to combat the sweeping epidemic of voter fraud in his state. Except that's not really a thing. In Florida and everywhere else, election fraud is rare. Nearly 11 million Floridians voted in 2020, a majority for Trump. And of those, the Florida Secretary of State's office says it referred just 75 complaints of election fraud to law enforcement. And election officials, including Ron DeSantis, have said that that election went smoothly. So what's the problem? Trump is the problem. He keeps lying about the election, complaining it was rigged, despite no evidence of it. So folks like DeSantis have to pretend that elections are under assault. They are, but by Republicans. So the new bill is more big government. DeSantis originally wanted $6 million and a staff of more than 50 officials to monitor election fraud that happens only anecdotally. Luckily, in the new legislation, he only gets $3.7 million and 25 new staffers and law enforcement officials. But that's still government waste for a problem that hardly exists. But who cares? The new Republican Party of Trump loves big government. Don't let them tell you differently. They especially love it when they can weaponize it against their favorite boogeymen. Minorities, women, gays, immigrants, Disney, the libs. Trump has so thoroughly corrupted the right and kicked out from underneath it the pillars of conservatism that once held it up. Now the leaders of the Republican Party stand for un-American and unconservative things like book banning, insurrection, lawlessness, and yes, big government. And nowhere is this on display more than in Ron DeSantis's Florida, where the governor is throwing everything but the kitchen sink at his re-election bid and presidential hopes. The Republican Party growing the size of government one totally unnecessary bill at a time. Okay, that's it for me. See you next week.